It's the Nymph and Dirge Singer Show.
Calling a young nigga phone. Where's Ollie with the motherfucking dog?
Hey guys, we're about to take level 11. Come and join. Farted, excuse me. Let's take level 11. Oopsies. Oh, farts are still funny to me. Gosh, my jump is still so low. I'm not used to it being that low. Alright, I'm going to take some time to explain to you. I'm going 1 to 20. I figured the 2 levels of rogue is great. But usually I have a lot more skill points to mess around with, right? Because going pure bard, you can't really do these, right? So check this out. What you would do if you're going to 30 is I would invest in intimidate. I would invest in, let's see, okay. Balance to 7. Jump until you can have a total mod of 40, of course. Perform max out. I would put points in tumble because it's fun. UMD. Concentration. And intimidation. Right? Because, why not? And, of course, if I have excess points, balance and swim. Haggle and diplomacies are also good to have, or even bluff, but diplomacy is fine because you don't get all that crazy aggro. Ooh. Ballad melody. That looks like my aura gets increased. Let's see. Oh, there it is. I'm inspiring. You have been inspired, gaining temporary hit points, healing application, and physical resistance. Let's see that. Ooh. Ooh, boy. Ooh, boy. Let's see this heal amp. Oh, I get 10 heal amp. Boy, oh boy. All right, first things first, I'm the realist. No, wait, let's do this first. Of course, as you notice, my charisma has gone up, so you're gonna want to keep that up. I would love 12-second cooldown with this 1 point, or I can get more PRR. Let's go ahead and just get that stun. Let's get some stun fun. And actually, shoopadoo. Let's take that back. I'm gonna tell you why. In a second, you want this because Scaldic Rage is a scam, boy. Alright, because one, you're going to get that. So, I either get 6 more PR or this is more important. Bam. Alright, I'm gonna reset this. You can get that love, boy. I'm liking the extra this, but I feel like that's gonna be the next thing I drop. Yeah. Let's go ahead and get that, right? Plus 6 MR is really good. My name is Well, you're gonna put that extra point where the hell I want, because that eventually that point's going right here. Right? You know? It doesn't really matter where I put that point, because the point... let's get a plus to save against spells. That's gonna be useful. Alright. So, of course, you want to reactivate that. I'm gonna put this silly dance thing right here. I'm gonna go over here, my Enhance Boys. Enhance Boys. And put this here. Now, with my Stun DC, the damn! Save 40 DC. That's plus 10. It's 10 plus your charisma modifier, half your bard level, so I would only get one more DC if I was a 4, plus your stun modifier. That's some good stuff. That's why, like, I love Swash, but sometimes I feel like going pure War Chanter would be just dope-ish. I've done it before. I've done I call it a War Buckler, where you're just mostly War Chanter. Slightly swashbuckler, and it works, but here's what you're missing out. Let me show you. You're missing out on the plus 5 damage, because, you know, precision, the insta kill, 6 more dodge, and of course, you know, I guess you'd be getting that. Yeah, you'd be getting that, maybe. And of course that, but you get Unyielding Sovereignty. It's called Kingly Recovery. You get the Super Duper Cleave, which is basically a little bit better version of, yeah. So at max, it's 14 plus your charisma modifier, plus half your bard levels, and stunning modifier. So that's really good. You get a plus 1 critical damage multiplier on attack rolls of 19-20. That's an extra multiplier. So, like, if you have a weapon that has, like, times 3, it'll be times 4. This is more damage. 6% more damage. And then, of course, I always... because, like, Rallying Cry, right? Everyone's like, oh, Rallying Cry. But you get Rallying Cry through PDK, and plus, honestly, getting a couple quickies ain't just when you can get... this goes up to 15% when you max it. So constant action, like, it doesn't stack with Sprint Boost, of course, but you ain't wasting any action boost. So that's everyone around you is moving 15% faster. So that's like 45%. Movement speed for everyone around you, so the whole party is going faster, and you don't have to use any quickies, anything that's constantly going, and it's constantly good. So both of these are really good melee trees, but coup de grace is really, 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 really good. I guess in this instance, with the 2 levels of rogue, I can actually I probably can get away with going War Buckler, because I'm not really worried about this. And then the cool thing about War Buckler is, of course, your Aria, your aura, this. See, Song of Heroism, crack-a-lacking at all times. Your aura gets stronger here. Spell Singer adds, makes this song really good. You know, right now this only gives me a plus 4 to skills. It's a whatever. And then this makes me a pretty decent finesse fighter, right? But even then, it only gives me to hit or to damage charisma. So, like, you would still need to fit out weapon finesse or anything if you have a dex. Like, right now, only getting a plus 8 to hit and all that can be a little bit better. I was using Dex, but that's not the case in this scenario. You would still want to go super duper charisma here, even though you're not getting. So I guess, yeah, it would make. You'd get a lot of really cool things. But here's another thing, is that you get freaking medium armor proficiency without arcane failure. This, yeah, by not taking it, you loosen up 2 AP, right? I spent 30 right here, and that means I would spend the majority of my points here. And actually, at this juncture, you could pretty much go either way, right? So at this point, between when you get 30 points in here, you can be like, do I want to go swash chanter or war buckler? And I'm gonna go out on the limb and say there's no wrong or right answer. You can get a lot of reflex saves and a lot of dodge here, a lot of crit potential and insta kill, and some, you know, damage. But this helps the party a lot more, in my opinion. You can give everyone 6. No, that's bullshit. You can give everyone damage reduction and damage reduction and PRR, and you can give everyone double shot and universal spell power, which sounds baller when you act. You know, you give them spell crit too, and faster movements. And this thing's actually pretty decent when you get hit by Plague Reaper in heroics. You get 3 uses, and you actually can tank a hit or two. You know, if you're going that way though, with Swash, you're not going to get the medium armor, because you need to be with this. You need to, you know, your swashbuckling requires you have finessable or thrown weapon in your main hand, wielding a buckler or nothing in your offhand, and wearing light to no armor. Druids cannot swashbuckle with knife. So I would go pure war chanter and dwarf or something. Like, I've done that before and get the medium armor. I wouldn't swash if you're trying to do medium armor. And Spellsinger is a chore, but it's super boss too. It's a chore because, you know, everyone's gonna want your songs. Your songs are gonna be wanted a lot by everyone. Everyone a lot wants songs by you. You know, you make the best music. Me, I'm the best chanter. I'll be going ooga dooga 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 ooga dooga 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 hum tum dooga dum drum drum drum, hitting on my drum, going into battle in Seattle. Watch the cattle. Alright. So first things first, get rid of this helmet. Second things second, say peace to the ring. Why? Because you're going to want this beast. Insightful deception, more sneak attack, more seeker, manslayer. That means everything can be a vorpal if it's humanoid-ish. Then you're going to want one of these babies. Concordant opposite HP item, gives you wisdom, diplomacy, haggle. And you have a chance of getting your spell points back. You get some constitution skills, some strength skills, which, you know, jump, swim, cool. And this one has a very heavy focus on concentration skills, which is actually pretty dope, because I don't take quicken on this build, I don't think. We'll find out together. Now let's go through the TR cache. Ooh, restoration greater. Let's see, 145%, because you're a boss. How much UMD do I have? Ah, yeah, I can stop putting points in UMD. I don't know why I still put points in UMD. I Okay, so let's see what's the UMG. Okay, 44 is good. If you can hit 44, you could probably stop. Let's see, 44, yeah. So these are big boys, big person scrolls. This is the adult scrolls. You're gonna love resurrection because it gives them some hit points. You don't want to be doing raised dead. You do raised dead because you have to do raised dead. But now we're in the zone where you don't have to do raised dead. Level 11 and up, you better give them some hit points on their way up, or they're in Reaper mode. They're just gonna get smacked. Most of the time, they don't have enough hit points anyway, and they're just gonna get smacked anyways. Sword of Shadows. 17 to 20 times 3 crit. Let's see. Compared to my 15 to 20 times 3. But here's the thing, is that I get 1 and a third 2d4s. Alright. And that's 2d6. And they're just so similar. The Sheridan's Rune is literally like, without the adamantine, I guess, a Sword of Shadows in its own. And you can get your own by doing CO6. There's dagger versions too. They're pretty nice. That's 2d3 daggers. It's nice if you're doing Vistani to dual wield those two. This is a baller short sword too. Hopefully, can't wait to grab that. I'm not going to use these goggles yet, that's for level 15. I have a whole set of HP items for different scenarios. Oh, here's my favorite stone skin, Clicky. If you don't have any other way to get stone skin, scrolls, you can get a Mintu, green steel. This is pretty nice because it's 12 minutes. It's actually pretty good stone skin Clicky, but you have to run against the Demon Queen raid to get it, and that's not super possible to a lot of people, but it's definitely something you should consider. A little spoiler, next level you get tons of good weapons and green steel, and you probably were peeping this out when I was leveling up before, but yeah, I have tons of green steel rapiers, and they're all as fun as hell. It may not put as much damage output as Sheridan's, but you know, you got my Mintu DR Breaker. So pretty. Oh yeah. It's 1d6, 15 to 20 times. Well, it's gonna be a times 3 modifier in my hand. You know how I roll. That's gonna, you know, be my DR breaker. Of course, when we get there. And, let's see what else we got. Crackle. I get my TR cachet. Bottomless flask of rum. I had. That was handy back in the old days. Ooh, my ooze. People are like, oh, if it's not a repeater, you shouldn't do. Oh man, I attack so fast. Single weapon fighting with this thing. This thing's one of my favorite toys. I gave it strength 6. Just, you know, because to hits from strength right now. But it also, Sundering Ooze, the AC, decreasing the opponent's AC, and it has a chance of. I'd be popping out oozes like crazy. Like, I probably won't be going around with 7 oozes, but I'll be going around with like 4 oozes, and that's actually something to write home about, in my opinion. I should have a triple positive. Always important. Yeah, here we go. Look at that. Heal amp. Charisma 6. That's probably a mistake. Competence and equipment, it's 100%. Sometimes I think going pure all 3 heal amp is dope, because you know, you get equipment somewhere else, like I am with my gloves, right? Or no, that's competence.
What?
Competence. That's the one you craft from hemp. So the 60%, but you're never gonna get 60% from in heroic. So like, I guess this is where it's at, right? You still get more from this and the equipment bonus. But you know, you tear through undead, and it's a raised dead clicky just in case you run out of scrolls. Now before this gets too long, let's dive into here real quick. I doubt there's anything in here that's gonna be my interest. I actually don't really change much gear at this point until level 15. Believe it or not. Pretty excited about ending this life and doing putting the whole 1 to 20 grind behind me. Do a couple 15 to 30 lives with do some iconics with Ginger and the crew before I split ways and I get my triple everything. I can bang out an iconic life and like probably do two iconic lives in a week. So once they're done and I'm done, I'm probably just gonna freaking zerg, get all my past lives and just sit at cap and just start raiding with the guild, you know, just start chilling. Maybe cap some tunes that I just never really worked on. You know, just start relaxing. Like, honestly, I've been grinding this game like a job. And that's no way to play a game. It's just gonna be nice to be able to just, like, I'm not gonna play the game today, because I don't have to. Oh, it's raid time. I'm gonna go hang out with the guild, you know? Kind of just, like, as I choose. Finally, I know, maybe help people gather Reaper points and all that. Well, I'll catch you guys in a quest. Let's see. Actually, before I let you guys go, I might as well show you what your Shiite is supposed to look like. Hit points on Fleek. My 95th Reaper point. I need to tell Voodoo that. So, bam. It's gonna be 48 in Reaper mode. Constitution. It's gonna be a little uneven, but I'll live. You know, it's better than non-even. Whatever. Light armor. I feel like this is pretty good. I feel like for my level that I'm performing at 100% capacity. So all this doohickey. Catch you guys in the quest. So here we are at the spiral.
Let me share it, please.
And the dead shall rise. I forgot to record another quest, so we're just gonna do this one for this video. Even though we have two turning clerics, I'll still be performing in certain situations. So you'll see.
Well, something cool I learned from Ina about this fountain. Does anybody here not know the little thing you can do with the tears that come from the fountain?
I have no idea.
When you turn undead and you don't have to have a good turn undead, just any turn undead, like even from a paladin, near that fountain, the fountain drops four of these things called tears of something, that they're gems on the ground. You pick those up. If you have those and you touch the altars that are like in the corner rooms where there's like a bunch of skeletons like further up, and there's a bunch of them like that, if you click the altar and you have those gems, it'll insta-kill all the undead in the room.
Oh, that's cool.
Which is cool because they're actually unique undead in that room. Like, the higher you get up, the zombie ones, you have to beat them down twice as a zombie and then as a skeleton, but the skeletons are non-Reaper mobs.
See, watch the floor here where the fountain is. See, there's four tiers of Dolara.
Yes, that's pretty cool.
Go ahead, pick them up. And once we get to those altars up there, try to click on them. We'll be turning shit, so we might not even get a chance to do that. But
I
remnant.
These are the altars he was talking about.
Yeah, you click on that altar up there and it insta-kills all the shit. Is that badass or what?
Yeah, that's cool.
Like, even if, it's like, even if you're running with a cleric that has like a shitty turn or a paladin, you know, that can't turn this shit, they can still turn on the fountain downstairs and get those. Please don't open any secret passages. Make sure we find them, but don't open them except for
someone. It's kind of like the big room in Zorian Cypher.
How so?
The big room where you have like the where you have to go across the forest bridge and all that fun stuff. If there's an altar in there, that if you turn undead, it kills everything on the lower floor.
Didn't know that.
That must be a lost code, because I hadn't seen that mechanic be used in any recent stuff.
I think we've air traps in this place before. End of the lead.
It's very Mortal Kombat-like traps, you know?
Yeah.
Leg.
Runs on me.
There's another one of those altars that you can click on with the gem.
Another fairy bird.
Do you have, Divine Punishment?
Yeah.
That's gonna be huge on the boss if you and I both got him dotted. Fuck, we should've done this in our 10. because if he and I are both hitting him with Divine Punishment and we're both wearing Spell Absorption, we're gonna be fucking fine.
Hello, Mama. Could I get a jump, please?
Yep.
I showed him.
Fucking permanent bullshit. Permanent gelatinous cube dot.
Might as well relog then, huh?
Will I have it when I raid?
If it's permanent, yes.
I did. Die right.
Still on your bar now?
No. Still on my nerves though.
There's no way to get rid of it. Cause he's dead now.
Well, log up bar went all the way. I guess I'll have to do it again.
You know your game is kind of fucked up when you can't log the fuck out.
I know, right?
Thank you.
See, when you get a permanent dot glitch, the only way to get rid of it is by jumping back into the source. Like, if you get it from lava, you just touch lava again. If you get it from a firewall, you know what I mean? Like, if you get it from a gelatinous cube, jump into the gelatinous cube again. If the source is gone, then you're probably just gonna have to re-log to the character selection and come back in. You see how the zombies turned into skeletons? It's just the uniqueness of these types of mobs in these corner rooms.
Those guys got used yet.
It's hard for a swashbuckler to damage certain mobs, especially liches, because they, I think the only thing that breaks their DR is bludgeon.
Well.
And, you know, you're mostly doing
you get level mob?
Well, I'll catch you guys in the leveling up segment.
Ian, I'm a little sick right now, but I swear, when I'm ready, I will fly south of it.